do graphic novels.
Wow.
So this is always based on a journalistic investigation. This is something we're doing on Syria with an artist from Syria. This, for example, is a graphic novel on right-wing terrorism. And this one sold very well. So it's based on, it's a journalistic investigation, but shown as a graphic novel.
Not a really big space, but they use it very, very well.
This is an event space, right? Could you just tell me a bit about what you do here?
Well, this is because we don't have much space. This is making things in one. It's a TV studio where we can do interviews. Sometimes after we do an investigation, we publish it, and then we invite some people from that field. And then it's something like a panel discussion with people here in the audience, but also stream it through Facebook so people can ask questions. Before, journalists would just print it, send off the newspaper and not care anymore.
Yeah.
But I think you need to engage the audience. It makes journalism better, but for us it's very important because we are funded by the public. So the public should be able to come here and talk to us. There's no advertisement involved, and that makes us more independent than, you know, even German newspapers. They really struggle because they depend a lot on the advertisement, and that gives powerful companies also influence in those newspapers. Journalists, they should just hold power and money to account. They should go out and do research and not just write down what politicians and business people tell them. That's good journalism. It doesn't take investigative journalism with internal sources and fancy stuff to be very important and to matter.